Not the first time Bashar al-Assad has used chemical weapons on his own people.
Nine on Your Side, Jennifer Martinez joins us now with the history of Syria attacks. Jennifer?
Well, the United States says that Syria has used chemical weapons at least 50 times since Syria's civil war began 7 years ago, and it is coming up to its eighth year. Tonight's announcement was in response to using chemical weapons on April 7th. President Donald Trump addressed the nation tonight to tell us the purpose.
The purpose of our actions tonight is to establish a strong deterrent against the production, spread, and use of chemical weapons. Establishing this deterrent is a vital national security interest of the United States. The combined American, British, and French response to these atrocities will integrate all instruments of our national power, military, economic, and diplomatic. We are prepared to sustain this response until the Syrian regime stops its use of prohibited chemical agents.
And last weekend's chemical weapons attack on the Syrian people was just the latest. In 2017, President Donald Trump ordered an airstrike on an air base in central Syria, the base where planes allegedly had launched chemical attacks. The United States struck the base with 58 missiles. This was in response to the chemical attack that killed more than 80 people. If you all remember the horrifying images of babies and adults gasping for air. Here's a little history for you on chemical attacks. In 2012, former President Barack Obama says the use of chemical weapons will not be tolerated by the Syrian regime. In 2013, a chemical attack killed more than 1,500 people, including children. Obama gave a speech saying that the United States should act against Syria, but said Congress should authorize any military action. Congress didn't act. But the United States then endorsed a Russian-backed plan to remove chemical stocks from Syria. More than 1,300 tons of chemical agents were removed. Chlorine was not part of that plan.
In 2013, President Putin and his government promised the world that they would guarantee the elimination of Syria's chemical weapons. Assad's recent attack and today's response are the direct result of Russia's failure to keep that promise. Russia must decide if it will continue down this dark path or if it will join with civilized nations as a force for stability and peace.
And more than 500,000 Syrians have died in this seven-year war. It is said that only a tiny percent of those have been killed from chemical strikes, as the vast majority have been killed by regime bombs, bullets, and barrel bombs. Stella?
Jenny, thank you. Just wonder why anyone would do something so horrible.